It is the same. Of course, they've worked it out how they can drain the salt out by putting in diversion drains. Now, it's not having any effect on the aquifer, and it's improving the land. The land is getting better because you're desalting it. A few background noises. We've got a metal door, neighbors across the road with sheep and goats, people trying to finish the water tank up above. We're in a rural village. Excuse the funny sound effects. I just put that in now before we get more of them. So back to Iraqi desaltation system. Now you're in the Fertile Crescent. The oldest city on earth is in between the Tigris and the Euphrates, and that is Erbil. Now Erbil and Damascus are both 12,000 years old of permanent occupation. Jericho, I can nearly see Jericho through the trees behind the camera, is 10,000 years of permanent occupation. But the two oldest, Erbil and Damascus in Syria, 12,000 years of permanent occupation. There's been a bit of deforestation, there's been a bit of changes to the environment, and there isn't enough trees in the total environment. And what happens is you get a leaching of salts. And it's not good putting the hyper-salinated water into the river, and it's not good if you use the river water again for irrigation, because you're bringing the salts back a little bit. The rain, not a problem. Now, if you aim that water towards systems that mitigate evaporation, which the Iraqis traditionally did, the largest diversity of date genetics in the world is between Baghdad and Basra, in between the Euphrates and the Tigris. So they actually worked in shade agriculture. They worked with gardens that were like crop gardens, no bigger than a quarter of an acre to half an acre, 1,000 to 2,000 square meters, because they knew to stop the land salting up, you've got to reduce the evaporation. And you do that with, hey, what's sitting right here? A date palm. This is a young one, only about 8 years old, started fruiting now, but it'll go on for a couple of hundred years. And shade these systems, reducing evaporation and making our systems more efficient. And the water then gets trapped in the root net of the trees around the small crop clearings. You can't go bigger. Now people have, they've salted the landscape with what we call modern industrial agriculture. To reverse it, we've got to desalinate to survive with these ditches, and then aim any water we're using towards not just crops and not just fast money systems, but permanent systems of perennial agriculture with small clearings in the middle. That's always the answer. You're going towards permanence at whatever it takes. And in really hot, dry landscapes, it's reducing evaporation. First thing you do with permaculture design in hot, arid is anti-evaporation strategies. So keep going, date palm. Got a lot of work to do for a long time. You're permanently employed. One of the great overstory combinations of dry lands, the date. But you need 40 degrees plus for 2 months. We've got a couple of days coming up at 41, just when our PDC starts. It's going to be torture for people who are not used to it. But you need plus 40 for over 2 months to get good fruit like this. That in America, that's 100 degrees for more than 100 days, they say. Another saying, American saying, the dates. Okay, let's move on. Another big question. Holly Cook. Northern New England, USA, cold temperate. Sounds like we've got a water pump in the background. Right? A lot of water gets delivered in this area. We're very deprived of water. The mains water comes on for just 2 hours a week. Right? So we fill tanks with that so we can drink and then bring in other water. Big story, but you need 20 times the area of water harvesting to one area of cropping. So on average in dry land, you need 20 acres of catchment to 1 acre of production.